Hey guys, it's Stephanie with Simarchy, and welcome to a house tour video of the base game homes in Sunset Valley, part 14. Oh my gosh, we maybe have five more videos of this series left, maybe a little bit more. I'm gonna try to squeeze in more houses into these because doing them two at a time just takes forever. And so today, let's just get right into it. Let me do a quick recap. It's been a while since I posted one of these. I will make sure to link the entire playlist in the description so you can go back and check those out. You don't have to have seen any of the previous ones to understand what's going on, but basically my friend Dora, shout out to Dora, recommended that I go through Sunset Valley and tour all of the homes that came with the base game so that you could check out what they look like and decide if you want to move into them or not. So that's basically what we're doing. So today we're jumping right into it with the Alto family. The Altos are new money. Their unscrumptious business practices have gotten them far in this town. Unfortunately, they own most of the local shops. Unofficially, they own most of the local shops. But how did their daughter become such a goody two-shoes? It doesn't make a whole lot of sense, but that's okay. They live in Villa Alto, a two-bedroom, two-bathroom home located at 20 Summerhill Court, and it's built on a 60-by-60 lot. I think this is one of the biggest houses in the game. And the description of the house says this executive home features multiple living areas and a stately home office. It is perfect for operating the family business or accommodating the family that is the business. Ooh. All right, let's go ahead and get right into this house now. And here we go. Whoa, this is already a super cool home. And I love how you can see just like a little bit of the faded hot air balloon right above it. Oh my gosh, there is a little pond out here, which I love anything that has to do with the water. So already I'm loving it. And the house is like this peachy pink, which is so freaking cute. It looks like a mansion from outside. We have a beautiful two-car garage. And I love how they outlined the driveway with these little stone paths. The landscaping is cute. We have some beautiful palm trees. Oh my gosh, this place looks gigantic. I even love the detail like right in the middle of the house here where they put like this wallpaper to make it look like not a trellis. It's cool. It's a cute little pattern. I love the octagonal room over here. It's sort of like a tower. Oh my gosh, so cool. At least I'm assuming it's octagonal. It could be hexagonal. I don't know. But still, either way, it's pretty cool. Oh my gosh, look at all the lush, beautiful flowers here. This is an impressive entranceway. Oh my gosh. Can you even get to the stairs behind this? Look, it's a tight squeeze, but you can. Whoa, this garden, this like little area here is just giving me so much inspiration. They only used a couple different flowers, but still it looks so luxurious and beautiful. And we have these awesome little balconies that go all the way around. Oh, I don't even know if we should jump to the backyard yet or if we should just see if there's a way to get there from inside the house. Oh my gosh, I feel like I could spend the whole 20 minutes just on this exterior, but I promise I won't do that. So let's go ahead and go in right here through the front door. Going through the front door. Oh, look at the staircase. Oh my gosh, and the wallpaper, it already looks so amazing. look at all the marble flooring. Oh my gosh, there's a mystery door right there. And oh, did I even turn the lights on? I should probably make sure to do that. Oh, look at this cute little sitting area. And there's definitely an out. Oh my gosh, the backyard. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh. I'm gonna save that for a little bit later. Oh my gosh, let me get the lights on real quick. You would think at this point I would remember to come in and turn the lights on, but I guess I don't want to lose that first reaction of me just coming in. So it's still a little tiny bit dark in here, but not too bad. And oh, there's another beautiful seating area over here. Very, very formal it looks like, but there is a TV, so you could definitely sit here and watch some TV. And I guess let's go through this door first. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited for this house already. Whoa, this is an office. And oh my gosh, look. They use the tiling to create like a separate little pattern right here in the middle, almost to look like, well, not like a rug, but just to kind of section off the area. The curtains look amazing in here. These beautiful bay windows. This is quite a study. It's very stately and luxurious. I'm probably going to use that word a lot. But look at the door. It has like a metal finish to it. It looks very nice. Oh my gosh. I'm very impressed. And we haven't even gone through the whole house yet. We have this giant staircase that goes upstairs, but I think there's a little room over here in this corner, right? Little room in the corner. Camera, please don't get distorted. This has to be a bathroom or something. It's so tiny. Oops, I forgot to pause, so a Sim snuck in here, but that's okay. It's her house. It is her house. So anyways, what was I doing? Going through this door. All right. Oh, it is a bathroom. Whoa, okay. I'm actually not too crazy about this. This looks dirty and filthy, and I know it's supposed to look high-end, but Oh my God, I would not pee in that thing. And no way, no how. I would go out in the bushes. All right, let's keep going. Oh my gosh, should we go to the backyard now? Let's go. Ooh, another Sim snuck in here. Well, I mean, I'm in their house. What am I talking about? I totally invaded their privacy. We've got a little phone over here. And I just went through her head. And we'll check out that yard in a second. Oh, look at this beautiful dining room. Oh my God, I really like the yellows and golds in here. We have the bust sculpture, which kind of looks really creepy in stone. Ugh. There's a radio back here, or a stereo set, I guess. Oh, I love the pattern on the chairs. So pretty. It definitely has a goldish yellow blue theme throughout this house, which I like. It looks good. The pattern on the couch is very cute too. I really like how they mix the flooring patterns to make these different, to make it look like little sectioned off areas. It's very cool. We have a bookshelf over here and a hanging wall shelf with lots of little trinkets. And I guess we'll go through this door next. I can't wait to go to the outside. Oh my gosh, but I want to finish this first floor before we do that. Oh, this is a bedroom. Ooh, purple and blue. Wow, that's a color combo you don't see very often, but I like it. I like the walls. I like the purple wood walls. Who would have thought to do that? I guess the Sims team did. We have some beautiful butterflies on the wall over here. And here's another one of these like metallic sheen doors. They look really cool. I'm going to try to do some more doors like that, definitely. And this room has a bathroom, a huge bathroom. There's a stand-up shower. A standalone shower is what I'm trying to say. A sink. I don't see a mirror. There's no mirror. And oh my God, the little lighting fixtures match the wallpaper. That's too much. That's too much. Too much. Too much pattern in here. I don't like it. Let's get out. This must go right back into this hallway or where? Oh, the kitchen. Okay, I'm turned around now. So I guess we were in the hallway here. We were in the dining room. I must have just completely skipped over that and went down that door. So here is the kitchen. So we have a little archway leading in here. A cute little side table with some sunflowers. Matching sunflower wall art way back there. I like this little breakfast bar type thing. It's really cute. But having all these appliances on top of there almost defeats the purpose of putting the stools. I don't even know if your Sim could sit down and have a proper meal there. We have trash compactor, dishwasher, sink, beautiful window, beautiful modern lighting. This house spared no expense. Look at the stove. Oh, nice stainless steel refrigerator. That looks really neat. They really played with patterns in this house, and I love it. I really love it. All right, so that's the door we went through that took us to the bathroom. And I think, unless I like totally missed something, I think it's safe to go outside. Oh my gosh, don't peek through the windows. Don't peek through the windows. I want to see it when we get out there and be surprised together. And here's one of the Sims that lives here again. Here's a close-up of her face. I'm sorry, I just took over your house. And gosh, even her sweater has a funky little pattern on it. All right, let's go outside. Oh my gosh, this is exciting. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh. I could tell I'm going to love this. Precious, cute, beautiful. The chairs match the pinky salmon-y color of the house. What a great little seating area. And oh my gosh, I never really thought, well, okay, I've put fencing around pools before, but not like this stone fencing with this, the stone pattern. It just makes it look more grand. Oh my gosh, they even put marble tiling, this pool is great. Oh my gosh. I love the marble tiling on the floor. I love the light blue color of the walls. It makes the water look so absolutely stunning and clear and clean. Ooh, I want their pool guy. And we have some lounge chair. Oh my gosh. Look at the view of Sunset Valley. Look at that view. It is stunning, breathtaking. But we have the lounge chairs in the same pinky peachy color and a little bar, a little tiki torches. Oh gosh. Well, we can't see the whole house because, hold on, let me page up a little bit. No, I can't do that in camera mode. Anyways, you saw what the house looked like. Well, no, you know what? Let me do that. Hold on. Page up. Okay, there we go. You see a better view of the home this way, and there's some columns. It looks like something missing. It looks like there should be a porch on top of this or something. Do I have this right? I'm all the way up. I'm all the way up, so I don't know. All right, well, here is a little bonfire area, and this looks weird, too. There's, like, a balcony on the bottom, but there's just columns there, and there's no door or window, so you can't get to it, and let's not check out the upstairs too much. Oh, my gosh, a little hedge maze. Well, it's not really a maze. Well, sort of. Oh, my God, that's cute. Wow, this house is really inspiring. Really inspiring. Let's lower the camera here a bit, and... Oh my gosh, this is what dreams are made of, guys. Look at this view. it's the best of both worlds. You have a beautiful shot of the city, and you also have a great shot of the ocean. Oh my gosh. Imagine a hot tub right here. That's what I would do. I would put a hot tub right there. Of course, there isn't one because this is a base game home. Oh my god, is this really a base game home? Is it really? That shocks me. That shocks me. What amazing detail they did. Oh my goodness. All right. Well, let's go back inside, I suppose. Although, let's be honest, I wouldn't mind staying out here for a while. Oh, camera's going slow. Let's creep on slowly through the back door. You know what? I'm just going to meet you upstairs. I will meet you upstairs in a second. All right. So as soon as we come up these stairs, we are greeted, well, with a hallway and then this room, which is just another sitting area. I guess with a house this big, you have to just create little nooks and corners with stuff. Otherwise, it's just a bunch of empty space. So I guess this is also just a little formal area to maybe sit down, have coffee, read a book, whatever. Ooh, and here's a beautiful bedroom. I love that this house doesn't have the same color theme throughout the entire house because it makes it definitely more interesting. And I was already sick of that blue and yellow downstairs. So well, I guess this is the same color as the outside of the home, but it's still very pretty, very nicely put together. Oh, so nice, so nice. Is this base game painting? Is it? I don't know. I feel like, is this house? It has to be base game. I don't know what I did. Whatever, let's keep going. Oh, what a bathroom. What a bathroom. Whoa, this is what we saw from the outside. I could see the patterns, but I couldn't tell what this room was. The mirrors just really open up the room a lot. I mean, it's already big as it is, but this makes it look way bigger. Very nice. We even have a golden toilet that's way better than that marble toilet that looks so dirty downstairs. Is this base? I need to check. Is this base game stuff? I'm really confused right now. I need to double check. All right, I went into build mode and double checked because I was a little bit thrown off. But yes, that painting we saw is base game and that bathtub is base game. I mean, I figured it had to be because I didn't change anything. But I guess I just forgot how many items the base game really came with. I played with so many packs and this really makes you appreciate the stuff that it came with. So maybe I'll do another base game build soon for you guys. But now we're going down this hallway again when we first came up the stairs and there's a whole other side of the house over here. Right away, I see a treadmill. Oh my gosh, I almost thought this mirror led to another room. It's really clear and beautiful. It makes it look, again, open and airy in here. Not like it's not a huge room already, but I guess that makes it even more huge. treadmill. I guess this is like an entertainment area. We have, oh, this is beautiful. Look at this. This is beautiful. Oh my goodness. We have a telescope, a chess table, an easel, and a guitar. Definitely lots of stuff to do. Lots of stuff to do in here is what I'm trying to say. Oh, there's even a cute little vanity. Oh my god, that's just adorable. And look at this shot. You can see the whole backyard from here. Oh, yes. Yes, that's a great view. All right, I think that's it. I feel like it was a little bit smaller. No, it's not small. I don't know what I'm trying to say. I feel like I want to see more, I think is what I'm trying to say. It's beautiful. I want more. I want it all. Let's do our floor shots. All right, so here we are on the second floor, just double checking I didn't miss anything. All the way to the left, we have that entertainment area. In the middle, we have the grand staircase. To the right of the staircase is another little seating area. And then all the way to the right of the home, we have a beautiful bedroom with its own gigantic bathroom. Definitely love the color tones up here. So let's go ahead and page down to the first level. And again, as soon as we first came in, we saw that grand staircase. To the left, we have a seating area with a TV and the study. The study is really cool. We also have that weird little bathroom there. And then to the right of the staircase, we have beautiful gigantic dining set. I did miss something. No, I didn't miss something. I sort of missed something. Well, here's the kitchen down on the bottom right hand corner of the bathroom and this purple and blue bedroom. I just missed this little corner here, I guess. These patterns are a bit funky, but there's another little seating area, TV, and video game console. So I definitely missed that corner of the room. And then here is a shot of the outside. Oh my gosh, just beautiful, just beautiful. So as always, I'm going to do my favorite shot of this house. Do I do that in the Sunset Valley tours? I can't remember. It's been so long. But either way, I'm going to do my favorite shot of this house. And this one's very clear for me. Clear being the key word because this pool looks so clear. It looks so clear, so clean, so pretty. I love this pool. I love this pool. I love this pool. How beautiful. just inspiring, and I want to swim in it so badly. So anyways, guys, I think it's time to move on to house number two. This was a big house, so this is going to be kind of a long tour, but I definitely want to squeeze at least two houses into this one, and then I think all the videos after this, I'm going to try to squeeze in three, but for now, let's just move on to house number two. All right, so here we are at house number two, and this is another gigantic one built on a 60 by 60 lot. This is right across the way from the Alto house that we just viewed, and this is the land grab house. And this is a very influential, I think, definitely an iconic family for the Sims games. You always hear people talking about the land grabs, and the description here says, the land grabs are old money. Nancy's family more or less founded the town. Oh, okay, that makes sense. I actually didn't know that. So it was no surprise that when she married Jeffrey, it was Jeffrey who changed his last name, not Nancy. If I ever get married, my husband's taking my last name, that's for sure. Will young Malcolm be a mild-mannered doctor like his father, or a voracious business tycoon like his mother? I don't know. All right, the land grab estate is a 3-bedroom, 4-bathroom home built on 10... located at 10 Summerhill Court, and again, built on a 60 by 60 lot, gigantic lot. The description says, this is an elegant home on the most exclusive circle in town. The stately manor resounds with grandeur. 4 fireplaces, a massive kitchen, formal and informal living areas, a large custom pool, 2-car garage, and an elegant neoclassical landscaping round out its elegant features. Wow, I am excited for this one. I absolutely love fireplaces. So let's go ahead and tour this house. We have this beautiful walkway that goes straight into the house, a curved driveway, and then this is just, I guess they made a gate out of walls? Is that what they did? They made like a gate around the property out of walls. That's pretty cool. Oh gosh, we're seeing inside. I don't want to see inside yet. Sorry about that. That's kind of weird. They're like little rooms with roofs, and it's just a gate. I don't know. It's cool. I like the concept. I like the idea. Not gonna knock on that. And I guess we'll just go inside now, right? I don't, what else can I say about this outside area? Let's go ahead and go inside. Going through the front door. Can't see anything because there's not any windows in it. Going through the front door. Woo. Woo, woo, woo. Beautiful grand entrance here. Oh, there's a ceiling glitch, so let's not pay any attention to that. It looks like you can go straight out into the backyard, so maybe... should we do that and then tour the inside? I don't know. I feel like it's so inviting. I definitely want to just go straight down this little hallway and see what's outside. And, ooh, I see a pool already. Definitely, I would imagine a house this big would have a pool. There is a cute little eating area out here with a tiki torch. And, wow, this is pretty cool. We've got some columns. And I totally missed the staircase. I'm just floating now. Floating in the air. Lots of little eating areas here. Very cute. What's this? Ooh, there's some lounge chairs. But I'm looking at this pond over here. Very cute. Very cute little pond. They just made these cool little structures out of columns and maybe half walls or foundation. Can't really tell. Don't think it's functional, just purely decorative. But gosh, that's pretty. Oh, look how they raised the terrain. Ooh. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful job. And talk about views. You can see everything from here too. You can't really see the city, but you definitely have a more secluded house over on the side, it looks like. So we can see the water, the ocean. Oh my gosh. All these, I don't want to call them mountains, but hills. Oh my gosh. So pretty. You don't have any neighbors looking into your backyard, that's for sure. Ooh, this pool is really cute too. But you see the difference between this one and the last one? Like, yes, this still looks beautiful and blue and inviting, but that other one looked crystal clear. We're just gonna fly over the pool because we can. Oh, there's a walkway over the pool. That's really interesting. They built a little terrace here with these columns and a roof, and there's a second pool over here. It's just a little, maybe I don't know. Maybe a kiddie pool? Wait, does it actually flow into the other one? It looked like it was separate at first. Now I'm not sure. Oh, it does. It flows right into the other one. That's interesting. I like that. That's a really cool touch. What was I looking at over here? Oh, we have another one of these maze, hedge maze thingies. It's just art. It's not really a maze, but that's really pretty. Wow. It's art. It's definitely art. And then here is a view of the house from the outside. Well, obviously from the outside in the back. So I think we're gonna go back down through this door that we came through and finish touring the inside of the first floor, and then we'll continue to what looks like two or three more floors. One or two more floors. We'll see. Going back in through the back door, going back in through the back door. All right, let's go left, I suppose. And it looks like, what is this? We have a grand entryway with some more columns. I did turn the lights on, but it's still dark. But this is just a cute little study. Gosh, it's dark. Is this a, okay, whoa, there's another archway into another part of the study. Oh, that's actually really interesting. Even though it is so dark in here, I can tell it's very, it's a cool layout, very cool layout. We have another grand archway. Wow, this house definitely loves its archways that goes into the formal living room. Well, maybe not so formal. I mean, sort of. It's formal, but there's a chess table. There is another cute little seating area right over here. I really love the patterns on these chairs. That is cute. I really like that. I feel like there should be a little table with tea right there in the middle. Is there a TV anywhere in here? No, but here's one of the fireplaces. Ooh, I have to admit though, the checkered or plaid, I guess, wall pattern definitely makes this house seem a little bit more old-fashioned than I'm sure it's supposed to be. The stone on the lamps, though, is a really cool touch. Makes them look like they're old and cracked. Yeah, this is really neat. I wish this study was a bit brighter. I would definitely throw some more lighting in here if this was my house. Because, I mean, you go from this deep, dark study into this beautiful, well-lit central entryway area here. And continuing on to the other side of the house, this reminds me of the last house we saw with this yellow and blue pattern. Although it's very pretty and sunny, it's a big, gigantic dining room. And I love how all of these rooms so far have also had an entrance to go out into the backyard. Oh, beautiful fireplace here. Just making this wall pop out. Wait, is that? I can't tell if, yeah, I guess they just painted the fireplace to match the wall. Yeah, that's what they did. It looks like it's popping right out of the wall. That's really neat. Oh, we have a door back here I almost missed. Probably a bathroom, I would imagine. And yeah, see, okay, this is the way you do a marble bathroom. You leave the toilet white. Otherwise, that toilet ends up looking dirty, just like this bathtub. Look at that. It looks dirty. It looks like it should be like in Silent Hill or something. I don't know. I don't know. That's a little bit creepy. A little bit creepy. There's doors to go outside, and then I would imagine this is a kitchen we're coming up to because I see some counters, and yeah, this is a nice kitchen. Wow, it's pretty big. It's pretty big. It's weird though. They have like the back of the fireplace poking out into the kitchen, which it does look weird, but it also makes it look like it's a stove, like a brick oven. Which it's not, but I mean, it reminds me of like a brick oven, a pizza oven, or something like that. We have the fridge and a little tiny sink over here. The kitchen's kind of weird. It's like separated into these little, I don't know, little sections. Little eat-in area here. I guess that's pretty cute. And then here's another corner of the kitchen. I don't know. I don't know. I'm not crazy about this kitchen, I will have to admit. I do like the coloring though. It looks very Italian. It looks like a pizza place. It looks like an Italian pizza place. I do like the double oven, so that's pretty cool. Oh, there was two sinks. Neat. Neat, neat, neat. All right. Where are we going? I guess. Is it time for the upstairs? Did we already tour the entire first floor? All right. Gosh, you forgot a ceiling in this room. That's okay. Let's go upstairs and see what we find. Okay, this makes a little bit more sense why there isn't a ceiling, I guess. Maybe. I don't know. Because it's. Why didn't we see that ceiling? Why did we see straight outside? You know, I'm not questioning it. Anyways, we have a loft area, so of course you could see downstairs from up here, which is really cool, really cool. We have a couple little sectioned off areas. Looks like this one is a, oh, it's an entertainment room, like a theater, a little home movie theater. I mean, sort of, I guess. Not really. I don't know. It's a TV area. Oh, I love the curtains. Those look really nice. Those fit perfectly on those windows. I've never seen them before, or I probably have and just never used them. All right, further down the hallway, we have a set of double glass doors that goes onto this little balcony, so you can see that beautiful yard from here. And directly across, we have a bedroom. Nice, nice. This is blue and yellow sort of still, but it's nicely done. I do like the bed. Whatever color they put on here really makes the wood pattern pop, or the intricate details of the wood, I mean. And the blue and white bedspread is very pretty. We have a little dresser back here with a tiny little photo on the wall. And I do like the dark blue walls. Those are pretty neat with that little yellow border. All right, going down the hallway even more, we have two more doors and another set of double doors that goes out to another balcony, which, there you go, another view. Let's go on this one first, and it is, this is a yellow bathroom. That's all I'm going to say about that. Yellow bathroom. All right, and this is a bedroom. It's a cool bedroom. It's a single bed, and it has a beautiful fireplace. We're starting to get distorted here. Let's see if I can fix this. That's a little bit better. It has like the treasure map wall print, which is pretty neat. Like I said, a single bed. There is this must be a kid's room, I suppose. Kid or a teenager. There's a little train set, a laptop on the computer desk, and a bookshelf, and a TV, and a video game console. That's pretty cool. It's a lot of pattern going on, though. Maybe a little bit too much. And I think, is this the door that we skipped? No. This was the blue bedroom. No. Did I get them all? Yeah, that's it. Okay, now let's go to the other side of the house. Going down. Ooh, now the camera's going fast. Going down to the other side of the house. This is probably a master bedroom, I would imagine, because it's like all the way down here by itself. And whoa, no, it's just a hallway into another part of the house. Huh. Really cool. I can't wait to see the floor plan of this. Really cool. Another balcony, another view of the pool. And I will go in this door. Well, I guess I'll go in it now. Let's go in it now. Whoa! What a bathroom! What a bathroom! Wow! This is regal. This is regal. I don't know if I like this creepy statue staring at you while you're peeing, though. That's a little weird. And a fireplace in the bathroom? Fireplace in the bathroom. Well, why not, I guess? A little magazine there with a chair. Wow, this is a bathroom. This is a bathroom. All right, further down the hallway. Uh-oh, camera, don't glitch on me now. We're almost done with this house. Another balcony, and okay, I guess it is a master bedroom. I guess it's its own wing of the house, which is really neat. the colors in here are okay, sort of like this gold and brownish, maroonish thing. I don't know, it has a little bit of an Asian vibe. There's that painting again that was in the other house. Again, I really like these window treatments. Really cool. And then back in this corner, we have a little dresser. Very nice. All right. I really want to see a floor plan of this house. Let's go ahead and go into our floor plan shots. All right. So here's a view of the second floor that we just toured. All the way to the right, we have two smaller bedrooms. And then all the way to the left, we have the master bedroom with a gigantic freaking bathroom that's bigger than the other two bedrooms. And in between the rooms, they built these little tiny rooms to hide the chimneys from the fireplace. There's one on this side and one on this side. And then we have the loft that goes straight downstairs. So yeah, they definitely like separated this out into wings of the house. That's how it feels. It feels very stately. And then here's an overall view of that backyard we were looking at. Pretty cool, pretty cool. And then we'll go down and do a view of the first floor in a second, but there is technically a third floor. It's just, I guess it's mainly from the roofing. It's an attic, I suppose, but you could probably expand this into living space, I would imagine. You could put a staircase, like, maybe, I don't know, somewhere. Somewhere you could squeeze one in. And then here is a overall shot of the first floor. So it's, I don't know, it's sort of just a giant rectangular house with a few little towers and pop-outs here and there. So the actual structure isn't that interesting when you really think about it, but it's still laid out pretty nicely. I felt like I really went on a tour of this place. So all the way on the left, we have the kitchen, followed by the dining room. The middle is this beautiful entryway with a staircase. And then to the right, we have the really oddly, dark oddly shaped study, sure, I'm making sense, and the living area all the way to the right. So this house was super interesting, and I have to come up with my favorite shot, which is going to be a little bit tough, because although this house is really cool, I don't think I had any real wow moments. This is going to be a little bit weird, but my favorite shot is this, the pond, right? I'm going to page up because I thought maybe these columns would have a little roof on them. No, I don't know. It's weird, but I like it. I like the raised terrain around the pond. I guess that's what really intrigued me. So weird to make this my favorite shot of the house, but it is. I'm not going to lie. Oh, look at the fish. Ooh, I'm going to hit play even though, oh my gosh, those are weird shaped fish. Is it just the way we're looking at them? I don't know. They're kind of creepy looking. Anyways, there we go. Favorite shot of the house, guys. I believe we're going to wrap up this video now. We saw two houses. It's a little bit long. It's not too long, but I will see you in the next video. Please don't forget to subscribe so that you don't miss it. And I hope you guys have a wonderful, wonderful day. Thanks for going on this tour with me. I will see you next time. Bye!